Audio Slave and Cause She's Then, of course, is Kerrang Radio. And I have Steve-O and Cohen from Sum 41 in the building. Hi.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Thanks for having us.
It's just me clapping.
That's
no
enough.
Producers here. That's
One's
enough.
Usually all we get. We're lucky to get one.
Oh, how are you both? You well?
We're good, yeah.
The rhythm section of Sum 41.
What an incredible summer you people are having here. Thank you very much. It's beautiful.
It's nice, isn't it?
It is very nice here in England. Raining. What a surprise.
It's just when you sort of fly back into the UK, isn't it? When you've been on holiday, go, current temperature in London Gatwick is 13 degrees.
I packed all this like summer clothing and then I looked in the suitcase and said, why the hell am I packing any like shorts or anything? I should have just put one big parka in the suitcase.
Exactly. Same pair of black jeans.
Yeah.
So you're here. Thank you very much for making the journey because you're playing the Casbah in Coventry tonight. Sold out show.
Yeah.
We sold out a while ago, actually. So there's a lot of hype surrounding the show tonight. What time sound check for you guys tonight?
I think we're sound checking at 3:30.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh, so 2 hours time.
Yeah, and I think we're on at around 8.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe later. I'm not sure.
I think it's 8.
Maybe 9.
Okay.
Okay.
Perfect.
8's a good time to go.
We'll go with that one because then if you see that, you'll definitely see the support band as well.
Yes.
So maybe 7. I don't know.
Let's go
to
7.
We don't know. We have no idea.
Let's say 8.
I don't even know where we're playing. I do, actually. It's at the Casbah. Say it. Say the cliche line. We are going to rock the Casbah. Has anybody said that?
Not yet.
I don't think anybody's ever said that before. Till now.
You got there first.
I just did it.
Strong work.
Thank you very much.
So you've got actually a guy who used to work here. His band is supporting you tonight, opening up, so that'd be nice. Templeton Peck, so that's all good.
Oh, yeah.
Why? Hold on, though. Like, why isn't he working here anymore? Is it somebody that we're like, that guy used to work here, and then we fired him?
No. There was just
so
a big,
bad.
There was a big kind of... cutting workforce with the recession stuff. There you go. Is that a good way of saying it?
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, buddy.
I feel awkward. No, that's all right.
Well,
it's okay.
Opportunities are out there. Yeah. We just gave you one. Sum 41 tonight at the where are we going?
Rocking the Casbah.
Come on.
We got an email about that band and we listened to it. They sound great.
Yeah, they're really good.
That was a hell of an email.
It's a good email blast.
Great email.
It was a blast.
Yeah, it was a blast.
So what can people expect from your live show tonight? Obviously, you'll be playing all the
songs.
Hits. Obviously.
Played in a set list through instruments.
New and old.
A PA. Yeah, old songs. Some songs I forgot we even knew we had.
Yeah, we've been practicing for the last
for
couple
2 days.
2 days, and we're playing songs that haven't played in like 10 years. So.
Oh, cool. That'll be
And
cool.
A lot of new ones, too.
Nice.
So, yeah. It's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
Well, I've never seen you live, so I should imagine it's quite a sort of lively show.
It's pretty lively.
Yeah.
Very lively.
Yeah.
Vivacious.
Vivacious, exactly. And so you had like 2 days in preparation before the show. Do you do that like production rehearsals before you go and do a big one?
Yeah. We just had about 2 months off, so we like to get together and go over stuff again.
Mm-hmm. Get fit again.
Refresh.
And yeah, exactly. And do you like do anything like shake the set list up when you're playing a lot? Because you play so many live shows. Do you sometimes not tell anyone the order and just kind of go with it and keep yourself kind of on the edge?
That was the idea on this one was that we had been playing so much late, like in the past, that we were always playing the same set list. So that's what we said to each other. We're like, let's play some songs we haven't played in 10 years. So
yeah,
that's
exactly.
When the idea came up. So we're going to play a lot of songs. Well, not a lot, but a few songs that we haven't played for a long time.
Maybe one song.
Yeah, I'm saying a lot now, and then we'll get there, and Derek will be like, we're just going to do one tonight.
Yeah, we'll do this one. But that one will blow everybody away.
It's going to be a hell of a one.
The Casbah. Will be rocked. Everybody will be very worried at the Casbah. What is a Casbah? Anyway, I don't know.
It says at the start of your Wikipedia page that you, which obviously is not true.
No.
And I'm sure that you don't write it at all. But it says that you play in excess of 300 shows a year.
That's an old fact. But it was true at one point.
At one point.
1 year we did, yeah.
I used to have on my Wikipedia page that, because I was saying in a bunch of interviews that I was the captain of the dive team. In high school, which our school didn't even have a dive team.
You can't swim.
I can't even really swim or, you know, but I said that I was because I said that I did all the stunts in the Into Deep video. And that became fact in a Wikipedia page. And then somebody's taking it off now. So I want it back on there because it is true.
Okay.
Can you swim?
Yes.
I don't believe
with the tide.
You.
I can swim. No, I'm okay. I can float.
Can you dive?
No. Not okay. off a high thing, though, because that would terrify me.
I can't dive either.
I can dive. In I was swim captain pool. Of the dive team.
Did you have a badge?
Yeah, but it was uncomfortable because, you know, a dive team, you wear the badge, but you're in little shorts, so you have to pin the badge to your chest. A lot of blood, very gross.
Yeah, it's not very good. Quite gross. So the album, of course, last year, you got nominated for Grammy, didn't you, for one track?
Yeah, we did.
We did.
Blood in My Eyes.
And we lost.
You did lose. Sorry to bring that up. But,
it's okay.
You brought it up. It's all right.
No, it's all right. I've moved on, you know.
But losing to the Foo Fighters, that's all right, isn't it?
Yeah, it's okay to lose to the Foo Fighters.
Yeah, they don't get enough Grammys.
Yeah, they're like, I suppose, I don't even know where I'm going to put this one.
You know, so did you go to the Grammys?
Like stirring a salad with it or something. He's just trying to find new ways. Anyway, it was nice.
I'm sorry to touch a nerve there. Did you go to the actual awards ceremony? Yeah.
We did, and we were there for, it's a really weird awards ceremony, actually. Like, we were sort of there. And there's a lot of, like, random categories that, you know, you just never even heard of or think that they have. And then they finally got to us. And when we saw the Foo Fighters there, we were like, this doesn't look good. And it was not good.
Yeah, we were kind of hoping they wouldn't show up.
Yeah, we were like, maybe they just won't come today.
Yeah,
and then they'll just scratch off Foo Fighters and write in Sum 41. I would still have taken it.
I reckon you'll get a Grammy, though, one day.
Sure.
Mm, yeah.
Why not?
It'd be nice to, though, wouldn't it? You've won loads of awards, haven't you?
We don't really, I mean, it was cool to be offered, what do you call it, nominated. So I think that's what I'm supposed to say. It was an honor being nominated. And I'm an honored nominee. That's what
I am. This is a good basis for your winner's speech. You can work off this.
I think I could. Yeah. I was ready to kill it, and I'd had quite a bit to drink, so I was ready to go out there and tell everybody, the committee or the association or the academy, or whatever they are, tell them what I think. But then I didn't get the chance because of that Dave Grohl.
Dave Grohl. Okay, so Scream Bloody Murder, the album. Yep. When are we going to hear... when are you going to come back and do a UK full tour? That's what lots of people are asking on Twitter. Do you know?
We don't know.
We're actually talking about that now.
Yeah.
So we are going to do one. We just need to find the right time, which is something that we don't know how to do.
I had this brilliant idea to do a full UK tour in August. I was told it wasn't the best time.
He's like, there's
something like the
Olympics are on. And, you know, we're not athletic enough to be playing it.
Oh, come on. They have diving at the Olympics.
I should do that. So that is that's not the dumbest idea. That is a great idea.
Anyway. I'm in.
We can work with that.
Let's work with it.
Yeah, it'll be fine. So where's the best part? You're online all the time, aren't you? On Twitter and Facebook and stuff like that.
Try to be.
Yeah.
We have no social life, so we use social networking to pretend that we have one.
I've got 20,000 friends. You've probably got way more than that.
You have personally 22,000?
I don't know. I have like a couple. The band has a few. You know, we get around. It's National Snogging Day, apparently. So if you snog, you can get more Twitters if you talk about snogging.
Oh, I wasn't talking about it for that purpose. But anyway.
I think you might have been.
Oh, I don't think I was.
I think you are. You're using hashtag to drum up some interest.
Let's play Screaming Bloody Murder now. And then you'll come back, We're going to talk about Fat Lip.
Yeah, sure.
Screaming Bloody Murder from Sum 41 then, and they are here. Well, the rhythm section are here in any case, Steve and Cohn, and we've had more coffee. The coffee's worked, hasn't it?
Yeah, and I'd like to just apologize to all of our English fans out there for not having a cuppa, but I like coffee, so I'm not going to have any tea.
I don't know
if that's insulting or not, but I am drinking out of an English-looking cup.
Yes, exactly. So you're playing at the Casbah and Coventry tonight. It's kind of like a warm-up show as well for NAS Festival, which is taking place this weekend as well. Some other people on the bill include Moses Steph and Pulled Apart by Horses and Lower Than Atlantis, all bands we play here, so that'll be good.
Sweet.
Do you do any extreme sports?
Aside from diving?
Yeah.
Well, you know, like I do a little extreme BMX biking and a little extreme motocross. I do a lot of extreme stuff. I don't actually do any extreme. I'm an extreme liar is what I like to lie extremely. Do you? Are you like, you do any of the, I can't really see you.
No, it's really badly designed, isn't it?
It's okay.
No, I don't really.
What about you? You got any? Not really. Nobody?
No.
Well, let's change the subject, because this isn't going anywhere.
I did do a 10-mile walk yesterday to raise money for charity.
That's extreme walking.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Well, that's good.
So that's good, isn't it? It's fine. And then I thought you were going back to Canada, but now you're going on a huge European tour for 5 weeks, right?
Yeah, we're here for 5 weeks.
Yeah, if it's in Europe... We are most likely going, but for the people that are elsewhere, we're not going, and we apologize.
What, are you going to any places you've never been before?
Bulgaria.
Mm-hmm.
Never been to Bulgaria. And to be honest, when I... And we've done Croatia in the past, too, and both those countries sort of sounded like, just to my sort of ignorant brain, I was like, oh, God, Bulgaria. And you just think, like, Soviet era kind of... It's gorgeous. Mm. I Googled it. I Googled Bulgaria, and it was amazing. I'm looking forward to it.
That's nice.
I'm so sure. I haven't been in, you know, Russia. We've been to, but a bunch
There's
of different
a couple
places.
Cities,
we get to go on this train. You take an overnight train. Conan and I are bunk buddies. In you take an overnight train from St. Petersburg to Moscow, which is pretty cool. That gets a little crazy.
Yep.
And
is he good at telling stories when you're going to sleep?
Oh, he's very quiet. Yeah.
I'm bad at telling stories when I'm awake, so it wouldn't be any better when I'm going to sleep.
That's like the vodka train. Some people get that train.
You know what's funny is that you do go on the vodka train, and everybody... Sorry to interrupt. I don't mean to interrupt you, but I would like to finish that sentence. You go on the train, and all these Russian guys, they all get the vodka out, but they all do it with little chasers, like with Fanta and a little cup.
Yeah,
they don't do mixed drinks there. Yeah,
no.
They don't mix them together. And they don't just drink the vodka. They have to have a tiny Fanta.
Orange Fanta.
It's orange. That's what Fanta is.
No, there's lemon.
I know, but isn't that a different kind? Like, there's Fanta lemon, but Fanta is orange.
I think a variety of citrus fruits.
I agree.
Anyway, but yeah, they drink it all the way to China on that train. Good, I agree too. Well, have a great show tonight.
Thank you.
Thanks
very
for
nice
be
to
amazing.
Meet you.
Amazing.
Nice. And your manager is very good at correspondence and sorting stuff out. He was on it.
Well, he almost got a punch in the face this morning when you woke up Steve.
Yeah, I was having a dream where I was being attacked, and then right when he was like, Steve, and he says it like that. He's like, Steve, and I was and I swung at him through the thing. Fortunately, I can't punch very hard.
That's good.
Yeah, it's great.
Enjoy your coffee.
Thank you.
Have a good gig tonight. Wrong. Tonight at the Casbah, Templeton Peck in support. You'll be playing this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
right.
This is Fat Lips, 741. Thank you, gents. Nice to meet you.
Thanks. Thank you.
In a bit.
Bye.